Hi students, in this video we shall continue exercise 2. So that is 7th problem. ABC is a right angle triangle in which angle A is equal to 90 degree and AB is equal to AC. Find angle B and angle C. So ABC is a right angle triangle in which angle A is equal to 90. Okay. So suppose if I draw the diagram, look like this. It is 90 degree A, B and C. Okay, and given that AB is equal to AC, AB is equal to AC, this is 90 degree. Okay. What we have to find? B and C. So now, in a triangle, if two sides are equal, then it is called isosceles triangle, right? So therefore, and also we know that in an isosceles triangle, angles opposite to equal sides are always equal. If these two sides are equal, then angles, these two angles which are opposite to those two sides are also equal. Okay, angle B is equal to angle C. So we have to find the value, that's all. So what we will write? Given thing, given angle A is equal to 90 degree and AB is equal to AC, that is given. Now since AB is equal to AC, angle B is equal to angle C. Okay, because isosceles triangle. It's a property of isosceles triangle. Angles opposite to equal sides are always equal. And also we know that sum of the interior angles is equal to 180 degree. That is, angle A plus angle B plus angle C is equal to 180 degree. Angle A is 90 degree plus angle B and C are equal. Let me consider it as X plus X. Both are equal. So I will consider X and X. And X plus X, 2X is equal to 180. I will take this 90 to the right hand side, minus 90. 2x is equal to 180 minus 90, that is 90. X is equal to 90 divided by 2. X is equal to 90 divided by 2. I think 45. So therefore angle B and C are 45. Therefore angle B is equal to 45. Angle C is equal to 45. Okay. So this is how you find solve the problem. Next we shall discuss some more criteria for congruence of triangles. So when we can say two triangles are congruent. Okay, so we discussed so far I think SAS congruence rule and ASA. So now we shall discuss SSS congruence rule. Okay, you have to write this in your notes. So what does this say? If three sides of one triangle are equal to the three sides of another triangle, then the two triangles are congruent. Okay, so in two triangle, if all the three sides of a triangle are equal to three sides of another triangle, then the two triangles are congruent. So that is, when you consider two triangles ABC and DEF, if AB is equal to DE and BC is equal to EF and AC is equal to DF. Okay, so AB is equal to DE, BC is equal to EF and AC is equal to DF are equal, then we can say that these two are congruent triangle. So it is not necessary that AB is equal to DE. It may be equal to EF and BC may be equal to DE and AC may be equal to DF, like that. Okay, but three measurements must be same. So if this triangle has measurements 4 5 6, this triangle also should have 4 5 6, so any order. Okay, so then we can say that two triangles are congruent. So this is SSS congruence rule. The next one is theorem RHS congruence rule. So RHS stands for right angle, hypotenuse and side. Okay, so what does this say? If in two right angle triangles, right angle triangle means one angle will be right angle, that is 90 degree, right, the hypotenuse and one side of one triangle are equal to the hypotenuse and one side of the other triangle, then the two triangles are congruent. Okay, so in two right angle triangles, if hypotenuse and one side are equal to hypotenuse and other and one side of another triangle, then those two triangles are congruent. So here you can see, if you consider two right angle triangles 90 degree here. Okay, then so if hypotenuse and one side, so any side BC or AB, okay, hypotenuse and the side which is opposite to 90 degree is called hypotenuse. This is hypotenuse. Okay, so hypotenuse. So here also it is hypotenuse. So in a right angle triangle, hypotenuse and any side BC or AB are equal to hypotenuse and one side. Okay, if then we can say that these two triangles are congruent triangle. Okay, so that is about RHS congruence rule. Okay, we shall discuss exercise 5.3. Triangle ABC and triangle DBC are two isosceles triangles on the same base BC, and vertices A and D are on the same side of BC. If AD is extended to intersect BC at P, show that triangle ABD congruent to triangle ACD, triangle ABP congruent to triangle ACP, AP bisects angle A as well as angle D, AP is perpendicular bisector of BC. Okay, ABC and DBC are two isosceles triangles. Means if these two are isosceles triangles on the same base, okay, then AB must be equal to AC as well as DB must be equal to DC. Okay, and vertices A and D are on the same side of BC. So vertices A and D are on the same side of BC. If AD is extended to meet P, BC extended to intersect BC at P. So here, show that ABD congruent to ACD. ABD congruent to ACD. These two triangles are congruent. Let us prove that. The first one, we have to prove these two triangles are congruent. So therefore, from triangle ABD and triangle ACD, AB is equal to AC. Okay, so because isosceles triangle. Then BD is equal to DC. BD is equal to DC because BDC is isosceles triangle, because triangle BDC is isosceles triangle. Okay, with side BD is equal to DC. Then AD is common. AD is equal to AD because common. Therefore, by SSS congruence rule. Triangle ABD congruent to triangle ACD. So these two triangles are congruent. Okay. Okay. Next, we shall prove second one. Triangle ABP congruent to triangle ACP. ABP and ACP. Okay. So second one, from triangle ABP and triangle ACP. Triangle ABP and ACP. So what are equal here? ABP and ACP. AB is equal to AC. AB is equal to AC because ABC is an isosceles triangle. Then what is equal? ABP. AP is common. AP is equal to AP. AP is equal to AP common. Is equal to AP common. Okay, so then make use of this angle, that is angle BAP is equal to angle CAP. So that is angle BAP is equal to angle CAP. So because, so why I can say this is because in the first case we have proved that ABD congruent to ACD. So that means corresponding side parts will be equal, that is these two angles will be equal. So therefore using CPCT of 1, I can say that these two angles are equal, because CPCT of 1. Okay. So now I can say that AB, AP and angle. So AB, AP and angle. Okay, included angle. So therefore I can use SAS congruence rule. Therefore by SAS congruence rule, what I can say, triangle ABP congruent to triangle ACP. So these triangles are congruent. So that is the second one. Okay. Okay, next we shall discuss third one. AP bisects angle A as well as angle D. Okay, now just now we have showed that these two angles are equal. So it is enough to say that AP bisects angle A. Okay, so third one we can say that angle BAP is equal to angle CAP. Okay, because CPCT of second, CPCT of second result. Okay, so therefore these two are equal. So which implies AP bisects angle A. So angle A. Third one. Okay, now in order to prove that AP bisects angle D, so here we have to show that these two angles are equal. Okay, so that means BDP must be equal to CDP. So to prove that, we will show that these two triangles are congruent. Okay, from triangle BDP and triangle CDP, BD is equal to CD. BD is equal to CD because triangle BDC is an isosceles triangle. It's triangle. Okay, that is the reason. Then angle DBP must be equal to angle DCP. DCP. So because these two angles are opposite to equal sides. So from the properties of isosceles triangle, angles opposite to equal sides are equal. So therefore DBP must be equal to DCP. Okay. Because angles opposite to equal sides. Then we can say that BP is equal to CP. So from the CPCT of second result, because ABP and ACP are congruent triangles, that means BP must be equal to CP. BP equal to CP because CPCT of second result. Okay. So therefore side angle side included angle. So therefore we can make use of SAS congruence rule. So therefore by congruence rule these two triangles, triangle BDP congruent to triangle CDP, therefore I can say that these two angles are equal, that is BDP is equal to CDP. Therefore angle BDP is equal to angle CDP because CPCT. So which implies AP bisects angle D. AP bisects angle D. Okay, next we have to prove that AP is perpendicular bisector of BC. That means AP is perpendicular to BC 90 degree. Okay, here both are 90 degree. And BP is equal to BC, that we have to prove. So just now we proved that triangle BDP congruence to triangle CDP, right? So using that we proved that these two angles are equal. So since these two are congruence, we can say that these two angles are equal, corresponding part CPCT, because these two angles are equal, we have considered. Okay, and also these two angles are equal, okay, because of CPCT of congruence triangles. Okay. So therefore, if these two are equal, then these two must be equal. Okay. So therefore, what we can write here from the CPCT of triangle BDP congruent to triangle CDP, angle BPD is equal to angle CPD. Okay, these two angles are equal. So since these two angles are linear pair angles, okay, sum of those two must be equal to 180 degree. Okay, linear pair angles. So since these two are equal, that means they must be equal to 90-90. So no other chance, okay, no other possibilities. So unless they are 90 degree, because sum of two are equal to 180 and those two are equal, then definitely they are equal to 90 degree. So therefore, and we can write angle BPD plus angle CPD is equal to 180 degree. So let us consider these two angles are equal, x plus x, and it is equal to 180 degree. 2x is equal to 180 degree. X is equal to 180 divided by 2, 2 ones are 2 nines are. So x is equal to 90 degree. So that means, angle BPD is equal to angle CPD is equal to 90 degree. Right? So therefore, we can say that AP is perpendicular bisector. AP is perpendicular bisector of BC. Next question. Two sides AB and BC and median AM of one triangle ABC are respectively equal to sides PQ and QR and median PN, okay, of triangle PQR. Show that triangle ABM congruent to triangle PQN, triangle ABC congruent to triangle PQR. So now here given that two sides AB and BC and median AM. Okay, median means a line which divides opposite side into equal half. BM is equal to MC. Okay, like that it divides. Of one triangle ABC are respectively equal to PQ, QR and median PN of triangle PQR. Okay, so that means AB equal to PQ, BC equal to QR and AM is equal to PN. Okay, so that is the meaning of given statement. We have to show that triangle ABM congruent to triangle PQN. Solution, first one, from triangle ABM and triangle PQN, we have to show that these two triangles are congruent. So we'll consider these two triangles. From these two triangles, AB is equal to PQ, okay, given, and AM is equal to PN, because given, okay, median, and BM is equal to QN, because median property. Using the median property, BM must be equal to QN. Okay, given that BC is equal to QR, since AM is median, AM and PN, median means it divides into two equal parts. Okay, so therefore BM must be equal to QN. So therefore, by all sides, SSS congruence rule, what we can say, triangle ABM congruent to triangle PQN. So these two triangles are congruent to each other. Okay. So that is the proof of first one. Second one, we have to prove triangle ABC congruent to triangle PQR. ABC, PQR, okay, big triangles. So from triangle ABC and triangle PQR. From triangle ABC and PQR, AB is equal to PQ. AB is equal to PQ. Right? It is given, because given. And now, so from the previous result, we have shown that these two triangles are congruent. Okay, that is ABM and PQN are congruent. So therefore, ABM, this angle must be equal to this angle. because CPCT of that result, congruence result. Okay, so therefore I can write angle ABC must be equal to angle PQR. Okay, ABM is same as ABC because same place we are considering. So therefore, because CPCT of result one, CPCT of result one. Okay, corresponding parts are equal. And I can say that BC is equal to QR, that is given. Okay, BC is equal to QR because given. So therefore, one side angle and another side included angle. So therefore, by SAS congruence rule, what we can say, triangle ABC congruent to triangle PQR. So this is the proof of second one. Next problem, ABC is an isosceles triangle with AB is equal to AC. Draw AP perpendicular to BC to show that angle B is equal to angle C. So I have to draw an isosceles triangle here with ABC. AB is equal to AC, so these two are equal. Okay, and I have to draw AP perpendicular to BC. So like this, AP perpendicular to BC means both angles are 90 degree. To show that angle B is equal to angle C. So we know that if we consider isosceles triangle, then two sides will be equal and angles opposite to those two sides are always equal. But now, so using this construction, we have to show that angle B is equal to angle C. So we'll think that we don't know the value of these two angles, okay, the property of these two angles. So using this construction, we have to show that these two angles are equal. Okay, so how we will see now. So AB is equal to AC is given AB is equal to AC, and construction AP perpendicular to BC. Okay, both angles are 90 degree. So now to show that these two angles are equal, I will show that these two triangles are congruent. Okay, from triangle ABP and triangle ACP. So now given that AB is equal to AC. Okay, AB is equal to AC because given. And you can see that both triangles are right angle triangles. Okay, so that is 90 degree. And these two sides are opposite to 90 degree. That means these two sides will become hypotenuse. So here to prove these two are congruent, I will make use of RHS congruence rule. Okay, hypotenuse are equal. And AP is common. AP is equal to AP is common. And this is 90 degree. Angle APB is equal to angle APC because 90 degree. Okay, therefore, by RHS congruence rule, so which is R right angle, okay, that is right angle, this is R, hypotenuse, this is hypotenuse, okay, and one side, so therefore by RHS congruence rule, we can say that triangle ABP congruent to triangle ACP, these two triangles are congruent. If these two are congruent, then these two angles are equal. So definitely these two are equal and these two angles are equal. So therefore, angle B is equal to angle C because CPCT, corresponding parts of congruent triangle. So this is how we can show that angle B is equal to angle C. So this completes your fifth chapter triangle. Okay, and the next concept you don't have for your syllabus, only up to here for your syllabus. And for SA1 exam, you have up to here. Okay, study well and do well in the exam.